Yeah, you say that the China growth story looks healthy as well, but it's kind of a crowded space in China when it comes to the EV market. Should it really be putting a lot of its eggs in the China basket?
Yeah, well, perfect question. And it's probably one of the most important things to focus on. I think if you look at what's happening, not only just in the Chinese opportunity for EV growth, but even the U.S.-China relations, is this going to have an impact to Tesla and other American companies in China? In terms of growth, there is a big opportunity. If you look at the upper middle and upper class, it's a very large market. It's bigger than the U.S. combined, as a whole. I think there's significant competition. They have a good brand. They are doing well at the high end. But as you point out, there is a lot of competition ramping right now, and we'll see what happens with the relations between the two countries.
Yeah, you would have just heard in our report there, of course, the delays when it comes to the truck space, the semi space. Is that going to be material going forward, do you think?
Yeah, I think it's something really important to pay attention to. What's really going to happen? If you look out 5+ years, a significant portion of the vehicles will be electronic. This is not a surprise. Everybody's expecting this. The largest car manufacturers in the world have already stated that a significant portion will be electric. Now, are they going to be able to compete with a technology company like Tesla? That will be remain to be seen. And that's really the biggest question, because how big is this market? Look at the market cap of Tesla, and we have to see where the growth opportunities are. And if they're able to get to tangential businesses, then it could be still very significant.